So the couple has asked you, the wedding vendor, to gather all of the COVID vaccine cards or all of the COVID vaccination electronic records of the wedding guests in order to determine who can come or who is barred from entering. In today's video, we're going to be talking about, is this legal? And if it is, what are the implications for keeping this information safe? Stick around. Hey out there, everybody. Welcome back to Wedding Industry Law. My name is Rob. I'm an attorney representing wedding industry professionals. And in this video, it's all about the legal implications of accepting guests, couples, or even other vendors' COVID-19 vaccination information. But we are not doing it alone. We have a fantastic attorney that's going to help us out and tackle these issues, help us to tackle these issues, I should say, not be tackled by them. We are the tacklers. So anyway, we have Wydad Suleiman on the program. Wydad is a litigator in Chapman Law Group civil litigation practice in Michigan, where she represents and defends physicians, pharmacists, and pain management specialists on anti-kickback statutes, Stark Law, False Claims Act, Medicare exclusion, and particularly relevant for today, HIPAA and high-tech data breach matters. She is a phenomenal attorney, very well versed in HIPAA law and privacy law as it pertains to protected healthcare information. So happy to have her on. Wydad, welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me.
All right. So I'm so glad that you're on because there's so much to unpack with this subject and these subjects, I would say. So let's start from the very beginning then. What is HIPAA and what does it mean to have a right of privacy with your medical stuff?
Yeah, so I mean, that's a great question. There's a lot packed in there, but essentially what HIPAA is, it's a federal privacy act that was created in 1996, and it aims to protect what we call protected health information, which essentially means just sensitive medical information that a patient might have when they go to the doctor. And essentially, it requires healthcare organizations and personnel to develop policies and procedures to protect that health information. And it also regulates when that information can be disclosed to other people or other doctors. And that's usually done only with the explicit, you know, written authorization from that patient. How HIPAA normally is implicated is usually in that example where a doctor wants to release some medical information about their patient to, let's say, another provider, and that would require the patient to step in and say, yep, I'm fine with that, and sign their statement, and then that information can be released.
So if I understand correctly, then HIPAA is really governs the behavior of the individual that possesses the information of another. So a doctor, another doctor, that kind of thing. It doesn't really govern the behavior of the patient, him or herself. Is that right?
Yeah, exactly. And a good way to think about it is, you know, you being the patient, it's up to you what you want to share or not share, since that's your protected, you know, sensitive information. It's what HIPAA really aims to do is to regulate the healthcare providers and the people working for those organizations about that information that they have. So HIPAA wouldn't necessarily come into play, for example, like with an airline where maybe they want to collect health information. They wouldn't necessarily be subject to HIPAA since it's aimed mainly at providers and healthcare organizations.
Right, because HIPAA is aimed at the healthcare providers. So in other words, if the airline or if, you know, the Carnival Cruise Line comes at you and is like, hey, are you sick? What's the deal with that? If you volunteer that to them, there is no implication of HIPAA. Is that my understanding?
Yes, exactly. Okay. So any information you volunteer, HIPAA does not come into play there.
Gotcha. So now, kind of now that we're kind of all on the same page, is there any understanding with the law right now? And I understand that everything is fluid. And just so that everybody out there understands, neither Wydad or myself are your attorney. Yes. And, you know, and so this area of the law, is moving fast. So even what we say now, don't rely on it completely, but but it could change next week. But with that being said, would the information contained on the average COVID vaccination card or COVID passport, as we're calling it, that indicates that you have been vaccinated, and the dates and all that kind of stuff, would that qualify as protected health information under HIPAA?
Yes. Currently, because that is record of your immunization history. So similar to if you get the annual flu vaccine, that's written somewhere in your patient file. It's the same idea as the vaccine card. It has your name. It has the medication that you received, which vaccine, when you received it. That would definitely be considered what we call PHI, personal health information.
So let's say then that the airlines or Carnival Cruise or just a Carnival. Hey, why not? I like to go to carnivals.
Yeah.
Let's say that we require proof of vaccination. Okay. Now, can you kind of talk about the idea of if they are getting that information through an email or through some type of online portal that they're using to book the ticket or to get into the carnival, to get on the cruise. Does that implicate HIPAA or implicate privacy because they're actually maintaining that private health information that was given to them voluntarily by the person that wants to ride on a cruise? Like, where are we at, even though they're not a medical provider? How does that work?
Yeah. So, I mean, that's a really good distinction. So just because, for example, the airline, the Carnival Cruise, or, you know, a vendor might be voluntarily given, let's say, vaccine information for their guests, there are still obligations for that person holding that information to protect it. When it comes to various states, privacy laws, there are regulations around privacy, identity theft regulations sometimes come into play. So just because HIPAA is not necessarily implicated because someone volunteered that information, now that you as the holder of that personal health information, it is considered, you know, private information, you need to make sure there are safeguards in place to protect that as well from other laws that potentially could be implicated if there was a breach or if, you know, that was disclosed to other people.
Great. And so that is, I guess that's the segue into the meat and potatoes of this video. And that is, to the extent that a planner, a venue operator, or any other professional in the wedding or event space is required or has a policy to accept information from the guests regarding their COVID vaccinations or gathering COVID vaccine information and COVID passports, to the extent that that information is retained by that wedding or event business, it needs to be protected somehow, right?
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
There are certain ways you can do that.
Yes, please go ahead. That's what's good. That you read my mind. So what are some best practices or even medium practices for protecting that information?
Yeah, absolutely. So just like with any kind of confidential information that you personally might have, there are some really basic steps that a lot of privacy professionals would tell you should still be implemented. So for example, making sure that you're using password protected places to store that information. So if you're using your own personal laptop or you're using some kind of iCloud sharing feature, just making sure that if you're collecting that information, there are safeguards in place where you as the vendor, as the person that's been provided that information, that no one else can have access to that. With passwords, there's something called two-factor authentication, which you hear often about. That is a pretty popular way nowadays that privacy regulators are telling people to make sure is on and active for many of their devices. And that's if anyone has Google, they know what this is, where you log into a profile that maybe you're not familiar with or the computer is not familiar with, you'll get a ping on your phone. So there's that two-factor, that double check to make sure that it is in fact you accessing that info. Other things that you can do, and it really is dependent on what the entity is, what kind of vendor it is. There are some kind of purging and record retention policies that you could put into place. And really what that means is if, for example, you have an event, you collect this information, because it was voluntarily given to you, and then the event is over, what is the reason for you to retain that information? If there isn't any reason, a safeguard would be, well, let me purge of it in a proper way. So that way there is no potential for a data breach of some sort. That's another way you could do that too. And it really depends on the way that you kind of keep your documents as well. If it's more physical and there's a lot of paper involved, putting into place some regulations like shredding even sometimes information that you might not necessarily need after an event or after something has been done would be a good way too.
So what I hear you say are two important things. Number one is when the wedding vendor is accepting that information, whether it's digital or through paper, that they have some type of quote unquote retention and destruction policy. So this, we're going to keep it cloud restricted, double password, mm-hmm. DEFCON 5, you know, your fingerprints, eyeball checks, retina scans. Okay. But the other thing that I heard you say, at least what I think I heard you say, is that the wedding vendor is likely committing some type of infraction, violating some type of law to the extent that they're using the information for purposes other than simply confirming the person has been vaccinated. So creating a list of these people and their vaccinations for some, I don't know, weird other reason, like, you know, I'm doing my own polling of who's vaccinated, who's not vaccinating, would also get you in trouble. Is that right?
Yeah. And every state is obviously has different regulations and different laws. So it's hard to say across the board what that might be, but just generally speaking, kind of from a 30,000 foot vantage point, if I gave you information solely for the purpose of attending your event or solely for the purpose of doing whatever it is that, the vendor might be contracted for, and you go ahead and utilize that information in another way that I did not consent to, that definitely brings in a lot of different implications. And you, as the person disclosing that information, definitely might feel like your privacy rights were infringed upon in some capacity because that wasn't its intended purpose.
Great. So at the end of the day, simply for the fact that a wedding vendor accepts a COVID vaccination card from a guest is not on its face a violation of HIPAA. It is, depending on how that wedding vendor uses the information and stores it, it could potentially be, if they don't store it correctly, a problem with whatever jurisdiction they're in, the privacy laws in that jurisdiction. But that's not to say that, you know, it can't be done. It's not to say that a wedding vendor could not take vaccination information in order to do an event.
Right, exactly. And really, it just depends on the whatever the entity or the vendor is participating in. I mean, there could be a way that the vendor insulates themselves from even really having to deal with that vaccination information. If, let's say, using weddings as an example, if the bride and groom are handling that kind of information and they then can handle the handling of the information from their guests, so that way it doesn't necessarily bring you into the fold, that might be a good way too to just kind of keep things a lot simpler where you're not necessarily handling that. But with your example where the vendor is required to collect that information, that definitely brings in kind of what we discussed earlier.
Well, this has been extremely informative, and we really appreciate you being on the show this week.
Yeah, thanks so much for having me. I'm more than happy to talk in the future. Like you said, HIPAA, the healthcare world, COVID, I mean, every day is just a changing landscape. And like you said, there are laws that are temporary right now because of the pandemic. There are laws that are being changed because of the pandemic. And I'm sure we're going to see a lot of different questions regarding privacy and what it is that vendors, people have to do moving forward so we can return to some, you know, semblance of normalcy.
I certainly hope you found this video informative. If you did, please be sure to smash the like button, as they say, hit the notification bell. Leave a comment if we didn't address something that you thought we should address. If you've got a suggestion for future episodes, I am always down to cover whatever the people want. New videos every week. Be sure to come back next week, check it out. And with that, folks, we'll see you next time.